10 reasons you shouldn't own a Lhasa Apso. Settling on a choice to own a dog is no easy task. Raising the dog is a more testier errand. It requires knowledge, courage, determination, and patience. Before getting a Lhasa Apso as a pet, you ought to consider 10 challenges that comes with possessing the Lhasa Apso breed. If you are asking yourself whether you are prepared to own a Lhasa Apso, then, at that point, you should really watch this video to the end, cause we will be talking about top 10 reasons you shouldn't own a Lhasa Apso. Hit the like button, subscribe button and turn on the bell notification icon, so you'll be notified when I drop another video. But before we engage into the video, if you would like a simple dog training strategy that will develop your dog hidden intelligence and create the obedient, well-behaved pet of your dreams, then click the link in the description to get access to the strategy that will reveal how you can quickly eliminate all bad behavioral problems. Let's dive in. 1. Lhasa Apso require regular grooming. The beautiful outward appearance of the dog doesn't stay as such naturally. Lhasa needs to be groomed regularly. It is a slow and careful process, as it should be done cautiously to avoid getting the dog injured. As a result of this slowness and care given to the dog, the grooming process takes up a ton of the owner's time. If grooming is not done regularly, the dog's fur will tangle and look like a mop. The grooming needs to be deep, if not the undercoat will develop mats over time which will be difficult to get rid of. 2. They are territorial. The Lhasa Apso is an extremely territorial dog. It truly values its own space and can be straightforwardly forceful to any individual who invades its territory or privacy. They are naturally bred as watchdogs, and it doesn't mess with intruders. It has a big dog character and will in general feel like the alpha in the home. This can bring on some issues, particularly if you have another pet. Regardless of whether it is a dog, cat or another animal, expect regular clashes between them and the Lhasa Apso. 3. They are highly temperamental. The Lhasa Apso is volatile and can't be pushed into doing anything. Its activities generally rely on its mood. One owner of the Lhasa Apso revealed that she began strolling her dog since it appeared to be excited, but halfway into the walk, her dog sat and wouldn't move. She was unable to get the dog to move and had to carry it home. This characteristic likewise makes the dog hard to train. It may flat out reject the training if it's not rewards for its obedience. 4. They are not ideal for toddlers and kids. If you have a toddler or kids in your home, then this isn't the best dog for your family. Since the dog is territorial, it does not take lightly with individuals who invade its privacy. Not excusing blameless and innocent kids. It likewise doesn't react softly to teasing and physical threats. Therefore, a misplaced child's foot or a slight pulling of its ears could lead the dog to bite whoever it sees as its attacker. 6. Lhasa Apso are very possessive. These dogs are extremely possessive to the point they can get aggressive and vicious. This happens especially with food. They will monitor their food, and any individual who attempts to take away their food, counting owners too, will face great opposition. They likewise forcefully protect their toys, and this is another reason they don't get along with toddlers and babies. 7. They dislike being left alone. They don't like being left alone. It requires steady attention and becomes sad when it is set to be alone. If you are quite often out and about, then this dog isn't really for you. For individuals who leave for work early and get back late, don't get this dog, except if you somebody who you can trust to deal with it. The dog can trash your home if it isn't house trained and is left all alone. 8. They are very barky. This dog bark doesn't match its body size. In Tibet, the spot of beginning of the dog, they were utter as watchdog to warn strangers of approaching outsiders who figured out how to slip the frontline edge guards. Be guaranteed that any stranger that approaches your home will be met with constant barking, which might turn out to be very unnerving and scary. 9. They are prone to eye problems. The dog's long hair comes with its portion of cons. One of them is the grooming, and another is the canine's eye issues. At the point when the hair becomes long and touches the eyes, the canine might develop a few issues like progressive retinal atrophy. This condition starts with symptoms like night blindness and ends with the dog turning out to be completely blind or partially blind. The dog may likewise foster cherry eye, which is brought about by a disease of the third eyelid, which causes a red swelling at the edge of the eye, subsequently the name cherry eye. 10. They are expensive to maintain. The Lhasa Apso is a sassy canine which require tons of attention. It is exposed to allergies and different diseases. They require constant shots and some nutrient supplements. The dog usually requires a lot of training, which is generally a reward-based training. It costs about $125 monthly to maintain the Lhasa Apso, in terms of food, training, shots, and health supplements. For most of the average individuals, this is a very pricey dog to keep. If this video was helpful to you, and you would love to see similar videos on your cats and dogs which will make you become a better pet owner, hit the like button, turn on the bell notification icon, and make sure you subscribe to the channel.